never told me why you set me free.
I didn't do it for you. I did it for the Seven Kingdoms.
Drunken dwarf will never be the savior of the Seven Kingdoms.
I don't believe in saviors. I believe men of talent have a part to play in the war to come.
If you sat on the Iron Throne, would you spread misery throughout the land?
I will never sit on the Iron Throne.
No, you won't. But you could help another climb those steps and take that seat.
What he built, it's ours. He built it for us. He meant it for us. They're going to try to take it away. All of it.
They?
All of them out there are enemies.
The man who murdered our father, he tore us apart. He's the enemy. I've been telling you for years. You've been defending him for years.
Exactly what they want.
And now our father is dead. That little monster is out there somewhere drawing breath.
Summons from the Queen.
It's a threat.
Of course it's a threat. Our daughter's alone in Dawn, surrounded by people who hate our family. They blame us for the death of Oberyn and his sister, and every other tragedy that's befallen their cursed country. I will burn their cities to the ground if they touch her! Our eldest child murdered at his own wedding. Our only daughter shipped off to Dawn. Our baby boy set to marry that smirking whore from Highgarden.
I'm gonna make things better.
You've never made anything better.
I'm going to Dawn. And I'm bringing our daughter home.
You can't just ask Prince Durand to give her back. She's promised to his son.
I'm not going to ask him anything.
You go down there with an army, it's an act of war.
No army.
You're going to Dawn. A one-handed man. Alone.
Never said I was going alone.
Game of faces.
That girl is not ready.
Clearly not.
I am ready.
For what?
For whatever you want. To be a faceless man. To be no one.
Where are you taking me?
Home.
The Boltons have Winterfell. Your marriage proposal, it wasn't for you.
Bruce Bolton murdered my brother. He betrayed my family. I can't marry him. You can't make me. He is a traitor, a murderer.
You're not marrying Bruce Bolton. No, you'll be marrying his son and heir, Ramsay. You've been a bystander to tragedy from the day they executed your father. Stop being a bystander. Do you hear me? Stop running. The North will be yours. Do you believe me?
I expect I'll be a married woman by the time you return.
Shut up.
She really is lovely. I hope I can make her happy.
I hope so too. I've become quite fond of Lady Sansa during our travels together. She's suffered enough.
I'll never hurt her. You have my word.
I'll be honest with you. I don't want to die. I'm burnt to death. I don't want people to remember me like that, scorched and screaming. But it's better than betraying everything I believe.
And what happens to your people? You'd rather burn than kneel, a great hero. Until winter comes, and the White Walkers come for us all, and there's no one left to sing. I think you're making a terrible mistake.
The freedom to make my own mistakes was all I ever wanted.
I ordered Matrey to burn at the stake. You prevented that order from being carried out. You showed mercy to Matrey. King's word is law. Show too much kindness, people won't fear you. If they don't fear you, they don't follow you.
Tonight, the Night's Watch elects a new Lord Commander. Sir Alistair Thorne is going to win.
Most likely.
Unpleasant man. He thinks you're a traitor.
Your bravery made him look weak. He'll punish you for it. I don't punish men for bravery. I reward them.
I don't doubt it, Your Grace. But I'm a brother of the Night's Watch. I pledge them my life, my honor, my sword. I don't know what I have left to give you.
You can give me the North. Kneel before me. Lay your sword at my feet. Pledge me your service and you'll rise again as Jon Stark, Lord of Winterfell.
It is time.
Sisters in Westeros. Westeros is west.
You're taking you to your sister.
You said you were taking me to the queen.
I am. Queen Daenerys Targaryen. She's the queen I serve.
What was that?
Sons of the Harpy.
Yes, Your Grace. They left it on the body.
They've never killed before.
It was only a matter of time, Your Grace. Conquerors always meet with resistance.
I did not take up residence in this pyramid so I could watch the city below decline into chaos.
The Sons of the Harpy will hear that message.
Make them very angry.
Angry snakes lash out. Makes chopping off their heads that much easier.
Your Grace, today is the traditional start of the fighting season.
I do not recognize this tradition.
Traditions are the only thing that will hold this city, your city, together. Without them, former slaves and former masters have nothing in common. nothing but centuries of mistrust and resentment. I can't promise this is the answer to all our problems, but it's a start.
Secure it, and use it as a base from which to operate. Then, we clean the city out. Neighborhood by neighborhood, street by street. Until the rats have nowhere left to hide.
I prefer your earlier suggestion. Round up the leaders of each of Marine's great families and bring them to me. I was wrong, and you were right. About a tradition. About bringing the people of this city together. I will reopen the fighting pits. To free men only. Slavery will never return to Marine.
Need a moment of your time. I brought you a gift.
It's true.
He has.
Who are you?
I am the gift. It's a pleasure to meet you, Your Grace.
How may I serve?
In the days before the Targaryens, the Faith Militant dispensed the justice of the sin. If I explain their holy purpose to my son, the King, I have no doubt he will sign a decree arming the believers you felt worthy.
An army that defends the bodies and souls of the common people.
An army in service to the gods themselves. And to you, of course, as the chosen representative of the Seven.
An honor I never expected. Or indeed, ever wished for.
Which is why you were chosen. You and I both know how the world works. Too often the wicked are the wealthiest, beyond the reach of justice. The King himself cannot always punish those who deserve it most.
All sinners are equal before the gods.
What would you say if I told you of a great sinner in our very midst, shielded by gold and privilege?
May the Father judge him justly.
The Loras of House Tyrell. You have broken the laws of gods and men.
Who do you think you are?
Justice.
Why is my brother in a cell?
I don't know. I didn't do it.
We both know who did.
You are aware of the rumors concerning you and Renly?
I don't pay attention to rumors.
How do you respond to these charges against your brother?
They are lies.
All of them?
All of them.
Queen Marjorie, in the presence of the gods, do you swear that your brother is innocent of these charges against him, to the best of your knowledge?
Yes, I swear it.
The faith is satisfied there is enough evidence to bring a formal trial for Ser Loras and Queen Marjorie.
What?
Bearing false witness before the gods is as grave a sin as any, my lady. Take her.
No! Tommen! You can't do this. I am the queen. Tommen! Tommen!
You saw her?
Yes.
And?
Her accommodations seem sufficient. What happens to her now?
Well, she and her brother are both being held under fair suspicion. A trial will be held for each of them. What will we find when we strip away your finery? A young man came to us not long ago. And he has much to say about you.
She's ready to become someone else.
My name is Lana. I'm an orphan. When I was 8, I begged enough money to buy my first bucket of oysters. I sold that bucket and made enough money to buy 2 more.
Your oysters fresh.
Best in the city.
You wouldn't lie to an old man, would you?
The man is a gambler. Lana will return to the docks. She will watch the gambler. She will come to know as much about him as she knows about herself.
And then what?
A gift.
Too old.
Bray,
but well worth it. I assure you.
Too old.
Made of dragon glass.
Dragon glass?
What the maesters call obsidian.
You know what it is. We have it in Dragonstone. Why would obsidian kill a walker?
I don't know.
Lady Melisandre told me that death marches on the wall.
I've seen it, Your Grace.
Seen what?
The army of the dead. When they come.
We have to know how to fight them. It's time.
For 8,000 years, the Night's Watch have sworn an oath to be the shield that guards the realms of men. And for 8,000 years, we've fallen short of that oath. You belong to the realms of men. All of you. Your people need a leader. And they need to get south of the wall before it's too late. We don't have much time, and they have less. The walkers are coming, and they'll hit your people first.
Most of them are at Hardhome. You're the Lord Commander of the Night's Watch. They need to hear it from you. They need to know the ships they are boarding won't be torched in the middle of the sea. You come with me, or I don't go.
You don't mean it, do you? Telling the wildlings you want to make peace. You're just doing it to trick them.
It's not a trick.
They burnt my village. They put an arrow through my father's head right in front of me. They butchered my mother, everyone I ever knew.
I know this is hard for you, but winter is coming. We know what's coming with it. We can't face it alone.
You vouch for this man, Tor.
He didn't have to come to Hardhome. He came because he needs us. And we need him.
I'll never trust a man in black. But I trust you, Tormund. If you say this is the way, we're with you.
This is the way.
Shut the gate!
40 horses died in the night. We'll lose more come sunset. We're running out of food. We can't open the supply line until the snow clears.
Find some healthy horses and a few knights to guard you. I'm sending you back to Castle Black. Tell the Lord Commander his king commands him to send food, supplies, fresh horses. In return, when I take the throne, I'll make sure the Night's Watch has all the men it requires.
Well, at least let me take Shireen. The siege is no place for a little girl.
My family stays with me. I've trusted in your visions, in your prophecies, for years.
You saw it yourself, my king. When you stared into the flames, a great battle in the snow. I have seen myself walk along the battlements of Winterfell. But sometimes sacrifices must be made to ensure victory. I have shown you the power of King's blood. And your blood runs through her veins.
If a man knows what he is and remains true to himself, the choice is no choice at all. He must fulfill his destiny and become who he is meant to be. However much he may hate it.
It's all right, Father.
You don't even know what I'm talking about.
It doesn't matter. I want to help you. Is there any way I can help?
What would you have me do with him? I swore I would kill him if he ever returned.
A ruler who kills those devoted to her is not a ruler who inspires devotion. You're going to need to inspire devotion, a lot of it, if you're ever going to rule across the narrow sea. But you cannot have him by your side when you do.
Remove Ser Jorah from the city.
Thank you.
have taken the first step on the path back to righteousness.
Am I free to go?
After your atonement.
One of the wildlings you brought back. Says he knows your Uncle Benjen. Says he's still alive.
Are you sure he's talking about Benjen? On the watch.